انسيكلوبيديا لماذا يوفي
When I looked up
بس
what
بدخل
beauty
יש
is
نتيعة
and
لمر
the
شي يوفي كشو سيمتريا
then usually, you know, it says that beauty has to do with symmetricity, proportion, but what you just explained is a much broader picture. So were I to say, define beauty, what is it, the way you perceive it? Beauty is the fulfillment that we get as a result of our inclusion, our integration with our natural system. Because beauty, it can be something else for different people, but it's around being natural. And the fact that I'm included in a system that's mine, like a baby that clings on to his mother's bosom. This is the feeling that I feel. By connecting with nature this way, by touching nature this way, there's something very close about it, something that's very much mine. It gives you a sense of home, security, fulfillment. And even though that there are many frightening phenomena in nature, tsunamis, hurricanes, volcanoes, and so on, along with it, they attract people because we see the power. And this power is attracting. It's magical. Magical how? Suppose this year I want to travel to the Far East. I have a pilot friend there. And we decided that he'll give us a small tour over the volcanoes in Kamchatka. It's a place where no man has been yet. And I'm already waiting to really feel the pleasure, to feel the power of the volcanoes, that it might explode beneath you. There's this fear and courage. And on the other hand, this intensity is attractive. It's yours. It's one of the phenomena from which once we were born, that once we were created by. That's how it is in nature. And also people that are closer to nature, they see, they say that there's nothing evil about nature, even though that as if there are such phenomena that one eats the other and so on, eventually it's completion. That's the wonder, that it all comes in a complete form. That these forms, these shapes of nature, they all complete each other. And that gives us a sense of completion, perfection, harmony. It's very special. And it's something that is above us. And also the people that research not only our planet, but also the entire universe, they are really impressed by it. I talked to such people because I wanted to become an astronomer. When I was a child, it was something very admirable. All the kids wanted to travel to space. And when I talked to them, and we talked many times, they always say that what we see, the stars that we see, and in general, everything that we're looking at is a computer. Don't think that these are stars. It's a system that is influencing us, and there's a thought behind it. When they look at the universe, they say that it's like looking at a brain. It's a thought. And this is how they feel. These are, you know, serious people, men, at the ages of 40, 50, that are very far from mysticism, scientists. But because they want to understand what's going on there, they don't just look at it as dead chunks roaming in space like we do, one going that way, the other going this way. No, they say that first of all, there's harmony there, but this harmony, it's not just harmony, it's a functioning brain. And they see the brain, and they're saying that it's only the expressions of the work of this brain. And they say that there's gray matter. They say that what we see is only a tiny particle out of millions or billions, not only in terms of distance, but also in terms of us not being able to see space, that it's not black or empty, but it's full of vitality, that it's full, like solid matter. But first of all, it's full of thought. It's fulfilled with thought, first and foremost. I heard it once, twice, three times, and they really impressed me. It's like a Bedouin in the desert. He feels that his place is alive. They also say it's alive and it's harmony. About something you said before. Previously you said that when we look at something virgin that mankind has not interfered with, that it works on us like a baby that feels that he's in his mother's arms. Now, I don't know how to explain to myself what you're saying, but the fact is that I feel that this is exactly how it is. When I have a moment to stop and look at that dry thorn on my way to work, it as if sucks me in. It's like a baby nursing on his mother's breasts. What does it give me? Harmony, completion, perfection. The perfection of plus and minus, heat and cold, pressure and I don't know what, this and that direction, that and this direction. Thousands and thousands of different phenomena in nature in all different directions. And how can you compare them all and connect them all? They're all connected and they all complete one another. We're built in such a way that we're looking for completion, perfection, harmony, in music, in art. Our entire culture is about it. Let's say that we're looking for harmony in our soul and only nature can provide us with it. Harmony, it means that I don't see in life contradicting distant things that are unrelated, but everything's interconnected. The most distant, opposite phenomena, and suddenly you feel how it all works together, and it gives birth to something just like a man and a woman give birth to a baby.